Good morning on Sunday morning. Today, being the first program for the month of May, even though it's not directly on the index of the ICDs or but today we are going to learn a lot out of all these three aspects. So before we start our today's program, I would request all the members to please rise on the scene for our institute motto. Today we have the structure today's program. It is a kind of a panel discussion on the interplay of index, ICDs and GST. And today's panelist, Sheth Naresh bhai Sheth, Sheth Milan bhai Mody and Sheth Gopal bhai Naresh put up their great efforts in compiling those case studies. And they have tried and covered most of the aspects. We have already shared the today's case study in our WhatsApp group. So hope all the members, they have the today's case study. And when yesterday we were discussing on the case studies and Naresh bhai was saying, when the clients approach us with respect to any of the queries, we normally look at that query from the ICD, whether if it is a query in relation to the GST, then we only reply from the GST perspective. We never come across, we never do a little research on the other aspects also, including ICDs and index. But let But then it may create some litigations in future. But nowadays the scenario is like that. While giving the advice to the client, it should be a kind of advice wherein all the aspects should be looked in. So without taking much more of time, and to introduce our today's panelists, I would like to invite our past convener and core group member, C. Sajjan by Kanodia.
Thank you, convener, dear friends. I feel very happy when I am interacting with you all after a period of 2 years. Last 2 years have been a tough time for each one of us. Due to COVID, we could not meet physically, but now gradually the things have been improving and we have started physical meetings. The today's topic and the faculty Naresh Bhai needs a good audience, but due to COVID restrictions, Naresh Bhai, we could have only the limited number of arrangement. Otherwise,
Sajjan ji, there is always a difference between crowd and audience. There are, you know, two learned people in the audience. It is enough for us. So we look for the audience, not for the crowd. Thank you, sir.
Quality matters.
Appreciate Naresh by your views, but at JB Nagar always there is a quality.
Yeah, and of course.
We feel happy when you are visiting at JB Nagar Study Circle, and the members are very much eager to listen. And today's topic is such that panel discussion on GST with combination of ICDS and PDS is a unique combination. And when I was interacting with Naresh Bhai, with this combination, they have given the presentation only at the limited platforms, large platforms, WRC, BCA, Chamber, and now it is our turn. So friends, we all are his kindness of Naresh Bhai that he always accept our request. So we all will be enriched today with the knowledge of all three learned faculties. Now, without taking much time, I would like to introduce the faculties. So the first is the Gopal Bhai Bora. He is partner at NHI and company with nearly 24 years of experience in direct tax. He is a bachelor degree in commerce from Ajmer University and qualified as chartered accountant in 1998. He has completed DISA and insolvency professional IBBA. He has advised a number of companies on corporate, including international tax matters and transfer. He has complete understanding of taxation laws, enable him to provide clients with comprehensive and accurate tax advice for their current and future business issues. His area of expertise includes tax compliance and litigation, transfer pricing, international taxation, and he is a regular contributor to WRC Referencer and regular contributor to. We have the seasoned faculty. For direct taxation, he will be enriching us on ICDS matters, clubbed with the GST and IndAS. So I welcome Gopal Bhai Bora. I request CH Income Shah and our bouquet as a mark of respect.
Good
Friends, we have CA Milan Mody with us. He is a rankist in both CA intermediate as well as CA final. And he is in practice since last 25 years. His area of expertise includes statutory audit, management audit, due diligence, IFRS and Ind AS. He is partner with Naresh and company. He has made about 50 presentations at various platforms, including BCA, WIRC and its branches, Chamber of Tax Consultants, various city study circle of WIRC. His topics covered in the presentations are internal audit, audit and assurance standard, Companies Act 2013, Ind AS, due diligence, corporate social responsibility, CSR, very important topic, Schedule 3 and carve-out, technical reviewer of annual report of ICAI award on excellence in financial reporting for 4 consecutive years from 15-16 to 19-20 and for the year 2021. He has authored various articles published in newspapers, online portals and professional journals published by BCA, CTC and ICAI on various technical topics, majority of which are pertaining to audit and assurance. BCA, WRC, CTC and presently a member of Chamber of Tax Consultants. Contributor of WRC governance manual. So friends, we have a seasoned faculty on Ind AS also. So with these words, I welcome Milan by Mody.
Request CA Jitendra Shah to present a flower bouquet and memento as a mark of respect.
Thank you, sir.
Now, friends, our friend by heart, attached to our study circle, Naresh by Sheth. He do not need any introduction, but still, I would like to introduce him in brief because if I go in detail, I will be taking this time. So, Naresh Bhai is in practice since 1982. Earlier, he was doing practice in individual name, and then he has been partner with Naresh and company. He is a well-known name in the indirect taxation. If you ask anyone who is Naresh Sheth, indirect taxation expert. He is a faculty in seminars organized by professional and business, and he has delivered more than 950 lectures on service tax, GST, etc. This is his quality. So, 950 is just starting. He has authored service tax publication on real estate sector, 3 editions published by BCA. He has authored GST section in WRC publication, Mahalera Manual, regular contributor to the indirect tax segment of annual references of WRC, visiting faculty for NACIN for their training session to officers, certified accredited GST trainer, regular contributor of articles in various professional source person of CREDAI, MCHI and supported them in representation various before various government and GST authorities. He is committee member of professional associations. Chairman of Indirect Tax Committee of Chamber of Tax Consultants for the year 1718 and 1919. Presently, core member of Indirect Tax Committee of Chamber of Tax Consultants, special invitee in the Indirect Tax Committee of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, New Delhi, for the year 1617. And there are many more things. So, with this brief introduction, I welcome Naresh Bhai Sheth.
To
Now I request C. Naresh by Sheth to start the session.
Friends, it is always a pleasure to be a I meet lot many friends, you know, and after the COVID time, let me tell you, last lecture I have given in the physical format in Goa in February 2020. After that, I think this is my first physical, presentation. And that too, you know, when I got the invitation from Jayesh bhai to come and speak over here, it was, you know, you are so pleased that, you know, you are getting the invitation from near and dear people, you know, to attend the marriage function or birthday party of the children. That kind of, you know, sort of a inner pleasure was there. So thank you very much for inviting all of us. And when Jayesh bhai told us about the topic, I said we should have a topic. Seeing the quality of the audience of the JB Nagar study circle, we should have an advanced topic, in the sense IND AS, ICDS, and you know, GST, interplay of that. Because today the client want view, 360 degree view of his problem, and it's a very big issue. Because, you know, if you are giving the advice for GST, you will be creating problem with income tax or in the audit or vice versa. So we have to have a solution which is, you know, workable or rather less hazardous. Because it's like, you know, medicine, you always have a side effect. If you have, you know, something good in the GST, you will have like a good doctor, you have to balance between the, you know, three things. So what is the best for the client? So today's topic, see, my role would be today, let me tell you, after understanding IND AS points from the Milan bhai and ICDS from the Gopal, I was so thankful to the God that I am in GST. GST is a much easier topic than IND AS and ICDS. So, you know, this is something, you know, first time I realized God has been kind to me and I have diverted into indirect tax, especially now in the GST. So IND AS is much complicated than what we know, and I am really amazed by the clarity of Milan when we discussed. And believe us, we have spent a lot of time in our office on this particular presentation because we are aware that it's a very complicated topic. And we are speaking before the very learned audience. So we have to, you know, be prepared. And perhaps, in my opinion, we are over prepared. So with this, you know, and that my role today would be, I'll be like sofa combat, in the sense, moderator also and panelist also. So I'll be playing a dual role. And the structure is like this. Because today, in today's panel discussion, the driver is IND AS. The reason is this, because in income tax and GST, you start from the balance sheet and financial statement, correct? So whatever Milan bhai does in the accounts, we have to follow that. So he's an engine today. He will be, you know, first putting his views on the case study as far as IND AS is concerned. Because once the accounts are finalized and signed, neither Gopal can do anything, I can do and cannot do anything. Because once the accounts are signed and filed or presented before GST authority, so whatever he does, you have to follow that. So the protocol will be, first Milan bhai will give the overview of the IND AS. This IND AS is applicable hai. Basic concepts of IND AS. He will just take, you know, three, four, five minutes on that. Then the Gopal will explain what is ICDS, to whom the ICDS is applicable, and what are the basic concepts of ICDs. Then I will take 1 or 2 minutes on the GST. Then we'll start on the case study proper. So I think this will be our protocol. This will be our the flow of our presentation. And we'll try to see, we have given the 15 case studies. We can't assure you that we can complete all 15. But generally what we have done, there are three baskets. One is the revenue recognition. See, the difference between Ind AS, ICDS, and GST is the revenue recognitions are at a different stage. When he recognizes the revenue, I may not recognize, and when we both recognize, he may not recognize the revenue in that particular year. So we have the basket where the 7 case studies are put on the revenue recognition. Thereafter, the second basket of the case study comes where there's a difference in the valuation. I think income tax goes on the real income concept, usually. Ind AS goes on the now, as a fair market value concept and other thing. Sometimes I wonder that company will manufacture the goods or they will manufacture the accounts. Because so much of the subjectivity is there. Sometimes I feel as such our old account schedule 6 with the limited car of things, we are finding it difficult, and our tax officer I don't know how much first of we'll understand, at least I'm not talking about the learned audience, but at least I personally feel I'm very deficient in understanding some of the accounting concept, because we have been taught then we have to unlearn, but what we have been taught when we were, the person who was introduced me as saying, suddenly I said, during that, our days, very inconsistent, etc. And now, when we are seeing, nothing it has cost. Conservatism, I don't know where it has gone. But this is something, and Milan rightly says, we can't blame the times, we can't blame anybody. We have to learn, unlearn, and relearn. So this is today the process. We'll be carrying out that. And some miscellaneous things, presentation, some of the very important aspects, like when you are selling the business, what will be treatment under the ICDS, what will be treatment under. So this kind of third basket we have kept it. Then operate, we are going to put the question on the lease also. Lease in the hands of the laser, lease in the hands of the lazy. So friends, with these small things, I will hand over Milan Bhai to explain the concepts and applicability of the Ind AS. And friend, 1 minute. I will just take only 1 minute. Generally, we feel if we are the mid-sized firm, we are the small firm. Why we should learn Ind AS? This is the general, the first question comes up. What you learn Ind AS? The reason is this, if you are doing GST, go to field form number 9C, correct? And if you are less than 5 crore rupees, you may not have to fill form number 9C now, but your officer, under the scrutiny, under the data mining exercise, you tell your balance sheet pe aapka 10 crore dikhta hai, tumne 3 crore dikhaya hai. Because, so you have to learn Ind AS, because you have to satisfy that officer. Okay, why, Milan Bhai is showing 10 crore and I am showing 3 crore rupees. So Ind AS, that's why it is important. So don't be under impression. Okay, I am a small firm, I am a proprietary concern, or I am a mid-sized firm, or even I am a very big firm, I am part of Big Four. I am doing only Ind AS. Why I should do about GST? The client of the Ind AS, whereas GST implication and this implication. So please don't be under impression that this particular panel discussion is only for some class of the people, it's for everybody. So with this small brief introduction, I will hand over the mic to Milan Bhai to explain the concepts of Ind AS. Yeah. And thereafter, Gopal, you take it over immediately for the ICDS. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Naresh. Yeah, good morning, everyone. And,
good morning.
And thank you, Naresh, for giving a brief overview in terms of the topic which we are going to discuss today. We were used to IDEP, and in IDEP, when I studied, it was mainly up to AS-15. AS-15 was one of the largest one, revised AS-15, which is on employee benefit. And then new standards kept on coming. So even in IDEP, there have been changes. And they have tried to now change the IDEP to the extent. So the principles of Ind AS, many of them are now getting converted. Coming to Ind AS, there was a lot of pressure. And hence, India also had to adopt IFRS. India chose to do a convergence by carving out certain sections of the IFRS and renamed it as Ind AS, because the institute wanted to say that we have completely adopted what IASB has prescribed under IFRS. So 1670 was the first, and there are four phases or four levels in which Ind AS became applicable. The first phase, it was listed company and unlisted company with net worth greater or equal to 500 crores. The question of how to compute worth, there were a lot of questions initially, you know, which type of reserves to be considered, not considered. That all has got settled because there are the ITFG. ITFG is the task force which was appointed, which gave guidance on many of the items. In terms of net worth or any other criteria. So 1670 was the first year when it became applicable. Now see the case like Government Act. So it may not be clear case what I am trying to say. But if there is a huge loss in a company, it's a very large company, to them, Ind AS will not be available. So, in terms of size, is maybe 10 times greater than an unlisted company with a 600 crore net worth. But so, there were a lot of questions during the. But nonetheless, we have to live with what is there. The phase 2 became applicable to listed companies other than net worth above 500 crores. So, every listed company, irrespective of its net worth, it became applicable. And for unlisted company, it was within the range of 250. So level 1 in 2016-17. And always remember that when you are applying, first you have to start with the opening reserve. You know, the transition. Transition is covered under Ind AS 101. We will not discuss about it because that's a problem. So that came to phase 2, which is other listed companies and unlisted companies between 250 crores to. The third bucket came NBFC, and there was a lot of resistance from NBFC also on the applicability because they felt that they are not being treated on par with banks. So to banks, so a large bank, Ind AS is not applicable, but a small NBFC, Ind AS is applicable. So that's the way it is. It was felt that if it is applied in a bank, a lot of erosion will happen in case of the bank, and there could not be public interest, or it will be prejudicial. So it was deferred for the banks and insurance companies. The last phase is so in the third phase, it was NBFCs which had a net worth greater or equal to 500 crores. And the last stage is NBFCs or NBFCs between the net worth of 250 crores to 500. So these are the four places where one of the greatest reason why people feel that India should be there is to have uniformity with internationally. When people look at IFRS accounts or US GAAP accounts, IGAAP was not to that level, and it is believed that if you have India account or IFRS accounts, and that would definitely help bring more investors. It will make the capital cost or the borrowing or the equity more lucrative for the company which is adopting in this. So it was considered as a framework or a governance structure which will, whether it has really happened or not, to some extent, yes, it has happened. But one thing which I personally, a lot of people who were used to reading IGAAP accounts, analysts, or they find it very difficult, to understand the Ind AS. So to some extent, they have left it on the company and the auditor to do justice to the Ind AS as it is. And then they have learned over the last 5-6 years. Lot of information, you know, the size of the account got increased as compared to IGAAP. Even first started with 2 pages, then 4 pages. But we all have to live with it rather than cribbing about it, because there has been a trust deficit in the auditor and whether they are doing their job correctly or not. So, sorry, not to divert from that topic, but this is what is there only in this applicability. Coming to the principles, what is the difference between an IGAAP and an Ind AS? There are a lot of differences. First of all, you have P&L, you have balance sheet, and you have cash flow. Here, there is an additional concept called OCI, which is other comprehensive income. There is a statement of changes in equity as another statement which is added. The lot of items, what Naresh bhai mentioned, everything was at cost. Now, there are a lot of principles of fair value which are embedded in many of the Ind AS. There is a concept of more disclosure, extensive disclosure, which were otherwise not required in the IGAAP. It goes based on the substance over form principle of the accounting standard, which was there and in writing. And the moment it becomes specified and in writing, you have no choice but to adopt it. And there is a concept of time value of money. So we had the time value of money only in AS 15 when we did an actuarial valuation, whereas the actuary used to do a present value of the future liability. Now that principle is adopted to each and every item in the P&L and the balance sheet. You know, so whether it is an asset, whether it is a liability, lot of items you may have to do a present value, and the interest component or the time value gets unwinded over a period of time. We will see it in some of the examples of leases. There are 3 examples of leases as well as on revenue. We will elaborate some portion of that over there. Yeah. Yeah, the next, I think, is there any question on Ind AS?
Yeah. I think what we'll do, Kiran bhai, we'll not invite the question from the floor. Otherwise, you'll be missing the case studies. And if there is anything is there at the end of the session,
we can do that.
Yes. Because whatever questions are there, we have covered in the our presentation. And whatever we have not covered, we don't know the answer. So there's no question. So,
good morning. Thank you, Naresh bhai. Thank you, Milan. I am going to read today is on income standard. So, as you all are aware, that the charging section under income tax, which is section 4 and section 5. Section 5 let down the scope, like what income to be taxable as far as the taxpayer is. So, like income accrued in India, accrued or arise or like, so there are three elements, so like resident, ordinary resident, and non-resident. So the scope is laid down in section 5 of the income tax. Then there is a section 14. In section 14, there are five head of incomes under which we have to compute the income. Once we know what are the head of income, then we go to the respective sections which deal with the computation of income. So currently, since you are dealing with the ICDs, which ICDs cover primarily the two head of income, one is income from business and profession, and second is income from other sources. And the head profit and gains of business, 244, and then income from other sources, section 56 and 57. Now then there is a section 145. So 145 is primarily talk about the method of accounting. So like when you have to or income from other sources, then there are methods which are defined. So currently under the Act, the two methods are there. One is market sum of accounting. And in Act, followed based on the generally accepted accounting policy. Then in 145, the power has been given to the Central Board of Direct Taxes in order to facilitate the computation of the total income. So originally, like there were two accounting standards. One was accounting policies, and then there was the prior period items. But really, those two accounting standards were not helping in terms of the computation of income, like how to compute the income. And then the people were, whatever that prescribed in the respective sections, people were computing, and then there were judicial precedent, people were following the judicial precedent. But so facilitated or to ease out the computation mechanism, so they notified certain accounting standard. Initially it was draft states, and in 2017, they issued the final accounting standards, the income computation disclosure standard. So again, the ICDs are not mandated to maintain the books of account. So books of account will continue to maintain as per our, but as Naresh bhai said, the tax computation start once the P&L is finalized. So in that, we will have to make adjustment if there is any variations, the ICDs or Ind AS. And the like what Milan has said, Naresh bhai said, that yes, there are certain like time value of money or fictional accounting, and ICDs may go into the real income theory. So you will have to find out, like, are there any difference between accounting treatment and tax treatment? If there are any difference, that treatment has to be captured into the income tax computations. And that, like, for like those who are in the tax audit, obviously the tax audit have a specified format where you can make the adjustment for the variations between ICDs and Ind AS. And then the difference will either added. ICDs are not applicable for individuals or NGOs who are not required to get their accounts audited. This is actually applicable when the tax audit is required, or like those who are following presumptive taxation. So of course you are not required to maintain books of account, but then there are certain items which you need to capture, like the turnover. So the turnover in India, there may be a different amount, but for you will have to compute. Account, but I may have to see what is the turnover or revenue as per India. What is the threshold that the tax audit or project to tax will have to take care of?
So now comes the GST. I will take only 1 minute. Friends, GST is a transaction tax. You agree with me? And it is a tax on the economic or commercial transactions. The personal transactions are not liable to GST. If I sell my personal car, I may not be liable to GST. If I sell my personal jewelry, I am not liable to GST. But if I am, as a jeweler, I am selling the jewelry, it is liable to GST. If I am using the car for my business and I am selling it, it may be liable to GST. And only today, only the alcoholic liquor for human consumption and the petroleum products that are out of GST. The rest of the thing is under the GST. GST has become like a god, you know, omnipresent everywhere. So this is something, you know, you have to understand. Only alcoholic liquor and petroleum products are out of the GST. Sometimes I wonder why petroleum products are out of the GST net. But because of the political reasons and political compulsion of the government, the tussle between the state and center, you know, this has been kept out of this thing. And I don't know about the alcoholic liquor, why it has been kept out of the GST. So, you know, but you know, this is the thing, GST are two things it does not apply. And why, you know, for this particular session, what is required to be understood? That GST Act provides for three things very clearly. What is the supply? Means what is taxable event? Taxable event is a supply, correct? Supply of goods or services. Then time of supply. We have section 12 and section 13 of the CGST Act, which provides the time of supply. What do you mean by time of supply? The point of time at which the taxable event occurs. That is the time of supply. That has been clearly given in the Act itself. Nobody, it's a sacrosanct. Neither the assessee nor the department, nor even the CBDT, CBEC rather in our case. Because they don't have, Parliament has not given any power to the subordinate authorities to change the time of supply through the notification rules or circular. So please understand, section 12 and 13 are totally sacrosanct, time of supply totally sacrosanct. And the value of the supply. Section 15 of the CGST Act, and we have rules 27 to 31, which are the valuation rules. So entire our, you know, the panel discussion will revolve around two things: time of supply, whether it is supply or not, time of supply, and the value of supply. I think these are the major points on which me, Milan, and Gopal will differ in the sense in the treatment. Otherwise, we are, you know, on the so. This is the thing. Now, what is the today's importance of today's session? See, as I have told you earlier, we can't really give the advice looking only one aspect. We require a lot of deliberation. If you are a corporate executive, I'm seeing many of my friends who are chief of their chief financial officers or head of their account department, taxation department. It is very easy for me to give advice on the GST. But you know, the person who lives by cabin, then will think that GST ka kya hoga, India ka kya hoga, or ICD ka kya hoga. So, you know, that's why we require a lot of deliberations on Ind-AS, ICD-AS, and the GST. And revenue declared in the financial statements would materially be different from revenue to be taxed under GST and revenue to be taxed under the income tax. Why the difference? Because of the timing difference in the revenue recognition. That is the four most important thing. He may recognize the income in 25 years. In one of the case studies, he's telling me you recognize income over the 25 years. And I have to recognize the income in the first year. And I don't know what Gopal will say. That will enunciate the time of the case study. So the timing difference of a revenue recognition. And please understand, GST is predominantly taxed on the transaction value. Only transaction value can be taxed. While in Ind AS, the fair market value concept comes. So there will be difference. There will be difference. Income tax is the predominantly, as I would say, real income, goes mostly on the real income concept. So what Milan accounts for and he takes, there will be totally difference. And you know, these are the things, you know, we'll see that in the time of our, you know, when we discuss the case studies. So now, there's a need for reconciliation at every stage. When we are doing the Article 6, there was only one reconciliation, bank reconciliation, correct? Bank statement is the book is a green tick, correct? An antique item that we used to make the reconciliation. Now your reconciliation everywhere. Reconcile your 3P with GST or 2P, you know, etc., etc., you know, reconciliation. See, chartered accountant ka now, you know, pura life reconciliation mein jata hai. All this, you know, professional reconciliation, reconcile with your spouse, reconcile with your children, reconcile with your partners, reconcile with your department, life mein,
and juniors.
So, you know, this is something, reconciliation is an ongoing process. So, you know, friends, but life is always a reconciliation, right? You have to reconcile with the circumstances, you have to reconcile with, you know, whatever, you know, you are facing with. So this particular thing teaches us, you know, how to reconcile without losing your mind, you know. So this is something, and again, reconcile arises because of the timing difference, valuation difference, etc., etc., etc. And friends, in the beginning, I'm telling you the legal principle. Most of my and Gopal's answer will revolve around this legal interpretation. Friends, it is settled jurisprudence that accounting treatment does not determine the tax treatment. Does? We have, you know, age-old celebrated judgment of Kedarnath Jute Manufacturing Company, right? Account mein kuch bhi karo. Our book, this book is, you know, prime. For GST and for his income tax act will be the prime. Secondly, we have the Sudhi Vallabhdas case. I think these are the two landmark cases, the law of a land. Whatever Milan does in accounts, it is his prerogative. But I have to go. I am obliged. It's no choice for me but to follow income tax act or to follow the GST law. Income tax law and GST law. So tax treatment, either GST treatment or income tax treatment, is independent of accounting treatment. And similarly, Milan told me, you say that. Similarly, accounting treatment is also independent of income tax and GST treatment. So this is something, you know, the beauty of the this topic today. Everybody does the, you know, what is mandated by Act. Milan also doing as per the Act. I am also doing as per Act. Gopal is also doing as per Act. But then the reconciliation. So I think this is the thing. Now, friends, with this, we'll start with the case studies proper. So let me take you to the first case study. I will explain briefly the facts. The fact is, we have a XYZ limited company which has raised the sales invoice of rupees 50 lakhs in financial year 2021, for which effective control of the goods or ownership, risk and reward in the ownership of the goods is not transferred to the buyer. For example, I am selling the goods on a door delivery basis to my customer. My sales complete only when the goods reaches his door. So the freight, insurance, all the things are on my account, on the account of the supplier. Even the transit loss, risk of the transit loss is on the supplier. So in that case, because please understand, as far as, you know, goods cannot move out of my factory unless and until I make an invoice, correct? Otherwise, no, EVP cannot be made and you cannot move the goods without EVP. So here our case study is, goods are removed from the factory in financial year 2021, say on the 15th March or 18th March 2021. And factory Noida is a Kochi is a, you know, customer. So the goods are really in the transit. Goods have not reached the customer, but invoice has been made at the Noida manufacturer in the 21, and the goods will reach to that person in 21-22, correct? I think, Vilayabhai, this is the brief facts of the case. And second thing would be, even from Noida to I am selling it to, say, Delhi. But my condition is that it's a high-tech machine. And that machine, unless and until I install properly and I check it, the customer says, if it functions properly,
I will not take the, you know, I will take the physical delivery, but legal delivery I will not take. So this is something, you know, these are the two cases where in one case, physical goods, effective control of the goods has not gone to the recipient. And the second case, perhaps, you know, effective goods, you know, the physical delivery has been made to the customer, but the performance obligation of the supplier of testing the machine has not been done. I think in these two cases, Milan bhai, what you will do the Ind AS accounting, and thereafter the Gopal will say what, how you will take, and then I will say what is my treatment, right?
Yeah. So, I think the answer is very apparent, at least in terms of the accounting standard of Ind AS. In Ind AS, there is a new standard, Ind AS 115, which will rule or which will be applicable in this particular case. The difference between the old standard and this 115 is more broader. They have tried to cover manufacturing and services, long-term contracts, everything in the one particular standard. But there is a little more above that, the concept of a performance obligation. So there is to be a contract with the customer, there is to be a separate price, and your obligation has to be fulfilled. In the first case, when it is in transit from the factory to the customer, the obligation is to deliver at the door. And hence, that obligation is not fulfilled, and hence, revenue cannot be recognized. Which means, even if your ERP system accounts for it as a sale, reversing that sales and bringing that item back in inventory at cost value. So in terms of the P&L impact, it will be the profit on this sale. There will be a difference between what you would have originally accounted back the inventory at cost. So that answer is very, very simple. Also, so there is no difference between Ind AS and normal comes to material which is in transit. And it also happens. So this is a cutoff procedure which on auditor. So it has left your factory. It is on the way to JNPT, but the it is still, maybe have. So in both those cases, the revenue will have to. On the second case, which is, it is, there are two conditions. One is that you are also responsible for installation of that machinery, and two, some amount of performance in terms of whether it is operating as per the specification when the order was given. Customer has to give a sign off. Now, these conditions means your performance obligation, but there is a slight catch over here. And that catch is that, let's say, if you are delivering the machinery independently and these services are independent. So, for example, if somebody wants that machinery without installation and this performance, then I will sell it at 45 lakhs, and the 5 lakhs I charge additionally for installation and for the satisfactory performance of the machinery. In which case, you will be completed one portion of the performance obligation and you will recognize 45 and defer. Or you have to defer only 5x, which is an independent performance. The way Naresh bhai has explained, it's interwoven with the transaction. And if that be the case, then you cannot separate it. It's a bundled item, and you will have to treat
account for. Entire 50 lakhs rupees. Okay. Yeah,
or as and when that performance is actually.
So the ICDS code deals with the revenue. term revenue. Revenue means the gross inflow of.
Gopali, is audible on the last row?
Yeah. So the revenue is a gross inflow of case receivables or other consumers. So the revenue recognition, if I read out what so then what, like it's a fact finding, so you have to find out the facts. Is there any difference between the accounts and tax, whether it fits into the definition? Then there will be no adjustment is required. If there is a difference, so like effective management, whether there is a control has been passed over, or if so on that aspect, ICDs and both are on similar line. But when it says that one of the item which like when element is missing into the ICD, if the revenue is not recognized on account of that, then there may be a difference between the tax treatment and accounting treatment. So going by the case study, so like in the first example, when the goods is given on door delivery, so my risk and reward also will pass on when the goods is delivered at the customer's destination. So in that event, for tax purpose also, I will have to recognize the revenue when the risk and reward is passed. So then there will be no adjustment. So at least on that part, we are on the same line. But when it comes to the second item, when there is installations and for accounting purpose, if you have to break like the installation charges separately, so ICDS doesn't recognize that part. So for ICDS purpose, because it's a gross inflow of revenue, and I say the revenue means it's a great gross case inflow. So you can't have the options to bifurcate unless, so like if it is a composite contract, you might bifurcate that.
Yeah. So Gopal, according to you, whatever Milan accounts for in the accounts, that is the same revenue you will be accounting. Particular example, Milan and Gopal, both their treatments are matching. Now I come to the GST treatment.
For installation, yeah. For installation.
Sorry, sir?
Between 45 and 5, which are 5 has to be received in subsequent.
So you want answer from Gopal,
yeah,
right?
Yes.
Yeah, Gopal, right. Yeah, Milan Bhai, well, I explained the case query. What Milan Bhai is saying, if there is a 45 lakh rupees standard cost of the machinery, right? And 5 lakhs you are charging separately for installation, correct? Then Gopal, what is saying? 45, Milan saying 45, he will account for in 2021, and installation income, he will account for in 2022, correct?
Yes.
So Gopal, what is your view?
Yeah, so it's a gross inflow. So you can't require, you are not required to bifurcate the 45.54 for ICDS. You will recognize 50 lakhs as a revenue. So that it will come into your tax audit ICDS adjustment.
And it will allow you to provide for expenses. Will it allow?
Yeah, so then what happens? So this is a revenue. So the expenditure of installation may go into the next year. So then your obligation is there to incur the expenditure. So you get expenditure based on your experience past. Yeah.
So now I come to the GST. GST is the most easy now. Very simple. Time of supply, section 12, section 13. 12 is for the goods, 13 is for the services. It's a very simple. The day on which you raise the invoice, that is the time of supply. And in the goods, we don't have any option. When the goods comes out of the factory gate, it has to be accompanied with the invoice. So, and when we are dealing with the goods in our present case study, we are dealing with the goods. So the date of raising of an invoice, section 31 is very clear. You have to remove the goods on, the removal. You have to raise the invoice on the removal of the goods. So this machinery of 50 lakh rupees, I have raised the invoice in March 21. So it is a revenue. I have to pay the tax in March 21. I have to declare in 3B of March 21. I have to declare in annual return for the 2021. So now, reconciliation. Because he does not account for anything in the March 21. And I am accounting 50 lakhs rupees. So there will be difference, correct?
officer will not mind because he's getting the revenue. The problem will come in the next year. Because next year he will show 50 lakhs rupees in the income and my GP shows zero. Officer will bounce on you. You are not disclosing the sales, etc., etc., etc. And these officers, poor people, do not know normal accounting. So, friend, on a serious note, it is a reconciliation item. Because Milan Bhai does not show revenue. I don't have a choice but to show the revenue. And then our auditor or our consultant do not have the choice but to go on with the reconciliations. I think this is the answer. Now I'll come to the second case study.
In relation to the expenses, provisional expenses we are making for income tax, we are making the provision of expenses.
I agree.
So what about the TDS, whether it will be on the provisional expenses, suppose in provision?
No, so that TDS is the noise.
Friends, you have a lot of ground to cover, right? And some of the tedious aspects are coming in the case study. The principle will be same, right? I think Gopal will take it that time, Otherwise, what will happen? We will not be able to complete our thing. But tedious aspect, we have taken into some of the case studies where Gopal will touch on. Okay, right? So now we go to the second case study. Raising the invoice. See, under the GST law, invoice has to be raised within 30 days from the provision of the services. And if, as per Milan Bhai, both are independent supplies, supply of the machine is independent, so I will raise the invoice of only of 45 SUPs. So 21 may 45 ka bill karunga, and 5 SUP bill I will do when the installation is complete. At that time, me and Milan will match. As far as service revenue is concerned.
Only catch there is, sometimes you may raise the full bill for 50, but accounting may be split by between 45 and 5. You don't have two separate bills. In which case, revenue accounting as per Ind AS will still be different. You will go by the invoice rate and not...
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, what you are saying is right, but sometimes that two splitting of invoices may not be commercially, and hence, you do it only for Ind AS.
So the right thing would be, if you want to really spread over these things, so make the invoice only separate. You see, that's the already difference between knowledge and wisdom. So wisdom would be So now let us come to the second case study. The second case study is very simple. XYZ Limited enters into a contract with Mr. A and Mr. B on 1st January for the sale of machine. We are talking of here, very complicated high-end machine, right? And XYZ sold this one machinery to Mr. A to 6 crore to be Milan Bhai. Not because anything love for the Milan Bhai, but he gives the money within 60 days. And he sells to the Gopal Bhai at 7 crore rupees. Because Gopal Bhai wants a credit term of 1 year. So 365 days. So the same machine sold in the same month to two different people, one at 6 crore, other at a 7 crore. So now, in our old days, we would have taken 6 crore and 7 crore in the sales and would have finished off. Okay, right? But after the Ind AS coming in, Milan Bhai has some different view on this. And
So under IGAP, what Naresh Bhai said is what would have done. 6 crore or 7 crores would have been accounted as sales. But when it comes to Ind AS, as I said, the time value of money has to be considered separately. And incidentally, this falls between two financial years. If it was one financial year, starting from April, the net amount would not be different.
Make the facts more clear.
Yeah.
So there's a difference of 1 crore rupees, correct? Yeah. And Gopal Bhai is getting 12 months credit, he's getting 2 months credit. So he's getting excess credit of 10 months. Standard credit 2 months credit card. He's getting 10 months. And unfortunately for the accountant, the 10 months, out of the 10 months, 1 month fall in 1920, right? And 9 months fall in a subsequent year, right? This is all the beauty of the case study with this fact.
Yeah. So in the second scenario where we get credit period of additional 10 months, and there is a difference in price at which you are selling. The difference in price is 1 crore for an additional credit of 10 months, which means it is 10 lakhs per month on a straight line basis. So 1 month of that falls in the financial year 2019-20. And hence 1 month's interest of 10 lakhs will be accounted in that year as an interest income. As an interest income in the subsequent year, which is 2021. And your revenue, which is the sale of. So you cannot say to customer selling the same goods, 1 at 6 crore and 1 at 7 crore. So my sales is 30. Sales remains as 12 crore. 1 crore additional, which you have got, is you have financed. It is as if of 6 crore and your recovery 1 crore as an interest on that loan, with part of it falling in one financial year and the 9 months falling in the subsequent financial
year. His property loss account is so sale of machinery. I am talking of 1920 where sale of machinery 12 crore.
Yes.
10 lakhs rupees he will show as an interest income or finance income, whatever it may be. And 90 lakhs rupees he will show in 2021, right? Am I right?
Yes, remember? Yes, sir.
So I see, yes, it's simple. Time value of money. So you have to just simply unwind the entries. So for the first year, so in the revenue, we get minus. So as I say, it's again like a task of the tax auditor has become more difficult to find out. Okay, like somebody has to examine okay, what is there in the income and what is there in the revenue. If there is some index adjustment where there is a time value money is factor.
So Naresh bhai, you mentioned something that index is more difficult.
What will happen? The gentleman raised the question. My profit and loss account will show 10 lakh rupees and 90 lakh rupees is interest rating. Then that officer will, my officer will see my balance sheet. Are 90 lakhs ka usko interest ka income mila kisne diya hai? Supplier ne diya, usne TDS nahi kaata hai. To shayad uske paas TDS ka inquiry ja bhi sakta hai. Itna mess hone wala hai, let me tell you. Out of this, so much mess will be created. We are assured of our professional work. For 7 lifetimes. Not only, So this is something, see, on a serious note, I am really failed to understand why government does not say whatever Milan does is final. Aap tax uske hisab se padho. This could have been the much better. Aur apna juna account kya galat tha yaar.
Customers, and if you are differentiating because of the credit period, then in substance over form, you are. So that is the strong argument, and people were misusing some of the accounting principles. And the preponement and postponement of income, and same way for expenses, is one of the biggest.
Month.
and machines are of a different kinds. Price is negotiated on so many other. So would you keep an account of every machine separately?
Yeah.
So this is the problem is not, see, maybe in substance you may be right, but sometimes the practicality, then what will happen? The auditor will do only audit of one company. Accountant, uski group company, there are 10 group companies. So kaun se company ka account, ek hi company ka account kar sakta hai wo. And to think of the GST consultant and the, you know, this person. Last day, 31st October, this is the reader for the
September
ko aata hai, and again the problem is hum to sab kilo jo ek hi aadhi baju ki cabin mein baithte hain, phir bhi unko mere paas aane ka time nahi milta, mere ko inke paas jane ka time milta hai. To yahan to kya hota hai, auditor aapka Delhi mein hai, you are sitting in Mumbai, and GST consultant somebody sitting in Calcutta also. This is possible and it is happening. So kaise reconcile karenge? So I think, you know, the practical difficulties will be there, but now, you know, Gopal is saying we will go over the real income concept and in GST, what will happen? GST.
Before you go on GST, I have one point.
Please
discuss with Manuel Bhai. You told that the 90 lakh is the just simple interest income. Yeah. But there is another factor of risk. You are giving the credit of 365 days. There may be possibility that you may not. So what about the risk factor of discounting?
And this expected credit loss is very beautiful. What it says is that day you say there is some risk involved from day one, and you make a part provision based on your risk for that expected loss. See, when you there is another concept which is very clear in AS, which means जब आपने उसको बेचा उसका क्रेडिट रेटिंग एजेंसी ने उसका डाउनग्रेड कर दिया और नाउ ही हैज बिकम फ्रॉम क्रेडिट, व्हिच मींस द रिस्क हैज इंक्रीज as far as IGAP is concerned, as well as Indias, unless from inception there is an answer. So at the recognition point, it will be tested for impairment or provision for doubtful.
As far as GST is concerned, GST is a tax on a transaction value. I have sold the machinery for 6 crore to one customer, another customer for 7 crore. And in our GST, we have one concept called, you know, the composite supply. Even if you treat this as, you know, combination, tax it on the basis of the predominant element of a supply. Here, the predominant element is a machine. I am dealer in the machine. I am not an NBFC to lend the money to the customer. So I will go for that. I will, you know, entire 5 crore, entire 6 crore rupees and 7 crore rupees will be taxed in the first year itself. And in my profit and loss account, 12 crore ka sell dikh raha hai, to mere ko 1 crore ka I have to make the adjustment, reconciliation in 9C, and 10 lakh rupees, jo Milan bhai ne income mein dala hai, wo mere ko less karke dikhana padega, to total 90 lakh rupees, and now I come to the next year. Milan bhai is showing 90 lakh rupees in the, you know, interest income. Interest income is as such exempt under the GST, but reconciliation will definitely be there because I have to reconcile the gross revenue under the GST. So I think this is what something we need to keep in mind. With this, I think we should go to the third case study. Yes, sir, please.
There will be another implication. GST will be charged from 6-7 crores.
Yes, sir.
Whereas they will show the sale of
6
crore.
Yes, sir.
So again, that reconciliation
also. Yeah. I think we finished in reconciliation. Of course. I think we finished, not your, ours, sir. I'm sorry.
Yes.
Our life is finished in the reconciliation.
The beauty part, the buyer and claim depreciation on 7 crores.
So when I started the practice, assessment mein IT apne paas detail manga tha na. Details of purchases, 1 lakh rupees ka sir. After jab unse 50,000 rupees tha. 50,000 tha sir. And then correspondingly wo sabko 133 kya bolte hai notice bhejte the. 136. Ki bhai Naresh bhai dikhata hai sales 2 crore rupees aapke naam ka. To Milan bhai bolega mere paas 2 crore nahi hai. Mere paas to kuch different figure hai. So, dono ke officers will be after them, you know. Yeah. So, I mean, these kind of things will
sir,
keep on happening. Yes, sir.
Are the corporates maintaining separate invoices, like one for tax invoice for GST purpose and one commercial? Are they allowed in, under any law? Are they prohibited under any law?
I don't think passing accounting adjustment entries. Once their, the final accounts trial balance is drawn up, they pass in their adjustment entries. So there are journal entries which are passed to give effect. Workings are generally done outside in Excel worksheets. Some sophisticated software, and that's where Naresh Bhai was saying, will I look at each sale invoice separately? There are programs which do this computation, and there are you.
Once I raise the invoice on the Milan bhai, whether the machinery is 6 crore ka ke 7 crore ka hai, I am raising the invoice for the consideration of 7 crore rupees. I have transferred the machinery to him. Then 7 crore ka how to account for? It is my internal matter, because court pe jayega to 7 crore ka invoice jayega sir, right? Yeah. I think this is the thing.
But wo commercial invoice or separate
shown
as separately
on the face of the
property. No, not on the face. It will be other the interest element due to Ind AS.
So this will also involve one more reconciliations. When you do the reconciliation of ICDS versus Ind AS, the accounting treatment. But what, assuming that interest income, when we fill the ITR, we fill the each line item of income, and interest income is shown as an interest income. Just imagine what CPC will do. CPC will just, if they say other income from other sources, there is no income. And if they, because CPC works in automation work. So we have to do one more reconciliation.
So one care which some people are now doing is they say interest income in accordance with Ind AS. Interest income, which is earned from a bank FD, is shown separately, and interest income, which is on account of this Ind AS, is shown as a separate. So that it's easier to explain. Not that everybody will understand it, but it is shown as a sometimes as a separate line.
I think these are the practical solutions we have to adopt. These are the practical solutions we have to adopt for the so that life of the tax consultant becomes easy.
Yeah.
Milan, the SLM for discussion purpose, you said 10
generally a 10 month credit period, you know. So, it's so but
sir, I have a case study, has separate case study, it's complicated.
So because it is less than 12 months,
I think IRR concept will take it into some other case study. It's there, already there. Sir, our presentation is like Gujarati Thali. You know,
So
I think you have to hire
Yeah, man.
अदर इनकम में इंटरेस्ट तो फिर वो ऑफिसर अलाउ नहीं कर
So what is your revenue? Your revenue is 13 crore. So as I said, you will have to convince to the tax officer. It's a sales only. So he will have to allow your 10-year deduction. Okay. So obviously you have to convince to the officer because then he will just go on the accounting treatment and then say, put an income from other sources. And when डिपार्टमेंट विल अंडरस्टैंड
मिलन भाई तो अपने को क्या करना पड़ेगा इंस्टेड ऑफ एड्रेसिंग यू नो द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट यू हैव टू एड्रेस टू द ऑफिसर्स
मोर एप्लीकेबल फ्रॉम फाइनेंशियल ईयर 17-18 ऑनवर्ड्स तो पेंडेमिक द असेसमेंट फॉर दोस पीरियड वाज नॉट पिक्ड अप सो लेट अस सी हाउ द टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट आई टेल यू आई कैन गिव द एग्जांपल इन वन ऑफ आवर क्लाइंट केस where there were index adjustment and there were time value money of adjustment. So we have excluded in the tax computations. So like we have, you cannot imagine the tax officer did not agree and had added entire income.
This level, now you know, you sort of work. Now friends, you know, we'll have to go slightly faster. So, but we'll not, we'll give you presentation. Our third case study is the sales with the warranty. Sales with the warranty, and our case is like this. XYZ Limited sells the machinery with three options are there. Ek to aapko standard warranty 6 crore rupees mein is standard warranty. Aapko 6 crore ka machine lena hai, and with that 1 year warranty will come to you. You don't have the option. Mereko 5.5 mein do, mereko warranty nahi chahiye. 6 crore ka lena hai aapko, aur aapko warranty 1 saal ka lena hai. Secondly, you can buy the machinery with the option with 3 year extended warranty at 6.5 crore rupees. Aapko standard ek saal ka warranty hai, you want, you know, for 3 years, you pay 6.5 crore rupees. You are paying extra 50 lakh rupees for extended warranty of 2 years. And tisra option company de rahi hai, 1 year standard warranty to hai aapka. Aap dekho humara warranty service kaisa hai. And after the end of 1 year, if you want to buy the warranty for 2 years, you have to pay us the 60 lakh rupees. Mm-hmm. Are you clear on this?
Yes.
So this is the case study. Milan by Ind AS.
Yeah. So again, quite simple because the answers are already there. You would have figured it out by now looking at the example itself and looking at the performance. Falls into 15 or 20 lakhs, you will make the provision for that one. So the first year is quite simple.
1 minute, you will swap it here. Okay.
Okay.
With okay. The first, you know, check out all of that. Correct.
Yes. Yes.
Mera GST bhi same line pe ja raha hai. Correct. No issue. Lucky. Aapka bhi ho?
Yeah. So that will come separately on the provision side.
Lekin aapka bhi level is same aa raha hai. Wow. Ek hi cheez mere ko bolo.
Wow. First time year mein.
Lekin Milan bhai jo provision kar rahe hain unke hisab se. आपको डिडक्शन मिलेगा कि नहीं? गोपाल भाई को मिलन भाई ने
600 कमिंग टू दैट
या
सो लाइक व्हाट फर्स्ट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट रेफरेंस स्टैंडर्ड वॉरंटी राइट
यस सर पहले साल की बात कर रहे हैं 6 करोड़ का उन्होंने बनाया अकाउंट में मेरे को प्रोविजन के साथ कोई लेना देना नहीं है जीएसटी को
नो सो
आई एम वेरी हैप्पी
नो सो फॉर टैक्स पर्पस रेवेन्यू विल रिमेन 6 करोड़ बट सिंस देयर इज अ वारंटी अटैच्ड टू इट सो देयर इज एन ऑब्लिगेशंस which I may have to incur the cost to repair. So I have to make the provisions for warranties and then I have to go based on ICD 10 which deals with the provisions. So based on the Supreme Court decision retro.
In this year, you are referring
a lot of Supreme Court decision, so I have to make the provisions and the decision identical into the ICDS 10,
which is scientific basis.
Scientific basis. Okay. Now I'll come to the second option. 3 year extended warranty. जब ये मशीनी बाई करता हूँ, I sign the contract कि मेरे को 3 साल का चाहिए. I pay 6.5 crore rupees to the machinery manufacturer. So what will be your treatment, Milan bhai?
I think the answer that the additional 50 lakhs which you are receiving, for which the services will be rendered in the third year. So how can I recognize revenue now? I have received the money. That's an advance which I have. Not equivalent to revenue recognition, right? That's point one. Point two, the 50 lakhs which I received, for which I will provide services in year. So revenue in year one will be. When I put the revenue in the second and the third year also same. But if there is a disproportionate cost which may be there between second and third, so I think the answer is very simple. 6, irrespective of the receipt of money.
I will show the revenue as 6.5 crore rupees, but simultaneously I will make the provision for my future obligations, which because that is based on my past. So eventually the net P&L will marry with the accounts because I will have a provisions, but I have to make a separate provision instead of.
नहीं लेकिन ये तो मिलन तो जो है second year and third year, right? और warranty का लेने के लिए. And you are recognizing 6.5 crore is a sale in the fourth year itself. So would you make, you know, your profit will not match because you will make the you know, provision on some scientific basis, which may not be exact.
Yeah, that may be possible.
Yeah,
profit element hai usme. Agar 40 lakhs ka cost hai aur 50 lakhs ka revenue hai, to 10 lakh ka profit prepone ho jayega tax purpose ke liye. In this me, it will come 5 lakhs in second and third.
So now in the GST, as I would, you know, explained earlier, there's a concept called composite supply, correct? And composite supply means when there are two or more taxable supplies which have been provided in a concurrent manner, in a co-joint manner, and which is naturally bundled in the core ordinary course of business, it is treated as a composite supply. An entire bundle will be taxed at the rate applicable to the principal supply. Machinery might be going at 5%. So, you know, officer cannot tell me if it is a 50 lakh warranty ka hai, so you pay the tax and the warranty is a service, you pay entire 6.5 crore rupees, which is, you know, I'm accounting revenue will be accounted for in the first year itself. So, in my opinion, I will be paying 6.5 crore rupees in the sale of machinery at a whatever rate is applicable. I will be paying the tax, and as far as reconciliation is concerned, so you know, 6 crore rupees as far as this machine is concerned, and he's showing 20, he's not recognizing the revenue at all. So, I will be having the reconciliation 6 crore sales as per accounts and 50 lakhs rupees. The warranty adjustment in that year, and then in the next 2 years, in the balance sheet 25-25 financial statement, so where I have to deduct for doing the 9C, I have to deduct saying that this income I have already taken for and paid the tax in the earlier year. I think this is the treatment. Now we come to the third case, where after the first year is over, aapne ye check out ka machine le liya hai. And he is very satisfied with my warranty services. And he comes to me, okay, you take the check of 60 rupees, you
and give me the additional warranty, extended warranty for 2 years. You know, by what would be your call?
Yeah. So nobody asked me this. Then it is 60 lakhs. So the 10 lakhs is the financing element indirectly. And even in the second example, you can account for financing element to say that 25-25, instead of that, I will recognize 30. So cross it up and book as an interest. That's why in this example, we have not taken it, though it is there in some of the other examples. But just to bring out the difference between 60 and 50 is a and the second year will be deferred to the next year. And the question of provision does not arise because the subsequently. That's why I said that 50 and 60. First year income is only 28, second year income is 32. Yeah. For the sake of simplicity and because we are looking at this, I said we do it in SLM 30. But yes, otherwise, yes.
What is income tax?
I have answered from the NDS. Let Gopal still give this
answer. We will start.
No, so income you will recognize on accrual basis for the expenses. So it will let's do you recognize income of 60 lakhs, but then your obligations to service is still there. So you will recognize the expenses based on your past experience.
So what is your ultimately what? He will account for 30 lakhs rupees as the revenue in the second year, and in third year he will show 30 lakhs rupees. He will show entire 60 lakhs rupees in his computation, and he will say 30 lakhs up. So 60 lakhs. What will be the provision?
Right?
Dono saal ka provision. I will listen to my GST now. 60 lakhs ka invoice. I am raising the day on which he signs the contract with me. So it is, I have to pay the tax on the same day. But it's not a compulsory. It's an independent supply of services. So machinery ka mera 5% ka rate hoga. If you don't take the machinery ke saath mein liya hota usne, so you would have paid 5% GST. So you know, this would be a marketing point for your marketing the product. Saath mein le lo aakar ke, right? So, you know, if you are taking this independently, if you are taking it independently, 60 lakh rupees, you are paying 18% GST in the year in which you are taking that extended warranty and the date on which you are raising the invoice. Now come to the reconciliation. Milan Bhai has shown only 30 lakh rupees in his profit and loss account, correct? I am showing 60. So, I have to take, you know, I have to say adjustment of 30 lakh rupees in that year. And in the next year, Milan Bhai is showing 30 as a revenue. I am showing 0 as a revenue. So this will be there. And don't ask me about the TDS complication. TDS complication jo hai, jab bhi main 60 lakh ka warranty leta hu, mere ko kaatna padta hai TDS samne wale ko. Yes. The 60 mein kaatna padta hai.
So they will the person who's taking the warranty. On 60 lakhs.
Account for 30 lakhs. Next year, 30 lakhs for TDS.
Carry forward.
This is what you know.
Reconciliation.
So, friends, you know. So, this is the actual now, you know, we are going now the fun, correct? The fun of reconciliation of result. But But conceptually, you have to understand, we are just now discussing the concept of reconciliation. So, you know, it will be an ongoing process, correct? So, I think we have concluded case study number three.
Reconciliation of reconciliations.
Of course, sir. Now, you know, first we'll have, you know, one more partner in our form, reconciliation partner.
Yeah. We'll have to reconcile over today's time also.
Yeah, we have to reconcile.
For only three cases.
Very, don't worry. See, equally, you know, in any presentation, it's like, you know, not robbing up, sir. It's like money given to your school going or you know college going son or daughter. Aapne pocket money de diya. Pehle 3 din pe khatam. So time ka bhi aisa hai. Pehle 3 ke study mein. Karo log na sir. Once you did na, ho jayega.
So we'll have to take break over on
that. Haan, so we, I was to break at 10:45 na? Yeah. Okay. So now you know, so though no more questions, please. Because Jayanbhai is very conscious about the time.
I am conscious about the further questions, sir.
Yeah. Then you are conscious about the time also, sir. So friends, you know, give me some liberty of going, you know, at our space, okay? So in order to, because, you know, we have to take flavor of case studies. We are only on the revenue recognition. So now, provision for expected sales return. This is one of the things. Where you know, because I'm seeing this, you know, with the case of a stale card, where you know, customer can return the goods within 1 year. You know, I'm seeing now, my daughter is purchasing online. So, jo aadmi online pe dene ko aata hai, dusre din wapis wo collect karne ko aata hai, receipt ke liye. Subah ko aata hai, aur sham ko aata hai wapis. You know, do teen din par mail banta hai. To main dekhta hu, you know. लेने का देने का अल्टीमेटली तो यू नो कुछ खरीदा तो ही नहीं
खरीदा ही होता है तो ऑर्डर भी होता है दो एलिमिनेट होते हैं एक वाला रखना है
तो यू नो दिस इज समथिंग यू नो आई हैव ऑलवेज बीन सीइंग मेरे को तो मालूम ही पड़ता है कि कंपनी कैसे कमाती होगी इसी तो केस ऑफ स्केल का नो वेल फाइनेंशियल यू नो वो एक साथ का ओवरऑल देता है sold 1,500 units at 10,000 rupees each. So 15 crore ka usse sale kiya hua hai, correct? 1 crore 50 lakhs. Chalo, theek hai, 1 crore 50 lakhs. And past trend shows 3% of the goods sold are returned in the next financial year. Lucky company, yeah. Only 3% is, you know, returned in the next year. So 45,000 ka, correct, 2 crore ma. 45,000 का गुड्स आर रिटर्न 450 का गुड्स आर रिटर्न व्हाट इज इंडियस इंप्लीकेशन मींस गिव द इंप्लीकेशन इन अ शॉर्ट
या
सो एंड रिकंसिलिएशन एस्पेक्ट ऑफ यही तो वी डोंट डिस्कस मच करेक्ट नो मोर रिकंसिलिएशन डिस्कशन ओनली कांसेप्ट डिस्कशन या
सो यू कैन नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज बेस्ड ऑन योर पास्ट ट्रेंड 3% इज अ रिटर्न सो टू दैट एक्सटेंट यू हैव टू रिवर्स योर You have to either make a provision for sales that goes under the grouping of sales or revenue, which will be 1,45,50,000, right?
Yeah.
So that is how sales will be recognized. Is whatever is the expectation. So, in fact, in this case, the account a possibility of a return, you don't recognize revenue. You recognize. Otherwise, a very strict view would be complete sale will be only a but they understand that certain industry have this
sales return will be lump sum or will be known sales return only? So, suppose balance sheet is finalized in April itself. So, how much percentage are only
past? Based on past history. Based on past history, sir. Okay. It cannot be. तो जो मार्च 21 में सेल किया तो वो रिटर्न कर सकता है बट यू हैव नॉट अर्नड इट बिकॉज़ देयर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी दैट यू विल नाउ अंडर इन दिस यू हैव टू रिवर्स द कंप्लीट of the full value and show the balance is in it.
Yeah, Gopal bhai.
If it is the first year of the company, then what will
management estimate? It will have to be an because the accounting your business projection or your plan, it has some. Now you say, I don't come. That's not an answer which is allowed under. So even when there is a concept of that judgment may go wrong, but you will still have.
Sales return. So it talks about the gross revenue from the sales.
Dead.
So now the question is ki, should I
provisional
pay tax on the 1.5 crore rupees or I have some adjustment? So now coming to the ICD statements, because you have a past practice, you know there are 3% of the total sales is getting returned. So you have to make the provisions for the expected sales return. So that to that extent you will reduce your
profit.
Revenue. But I think somebody raised the question if there is no past experience, it is the first year of operations. So then you don't have the practice, the past experience. So then whether this provision is reasonable or not, that again is a subjectivity. So in that case, one can take a position in the year in which actually sales return happens. So that will
be industry practice. Yes. Yeah. Industry practice could be one of
yeah, or otherwise industry.
Crossword may example yeah. After 1 month also you can go and return the book.
Yeah.
So actually you can read the book and give it back.
Our client only, I'm knowing is the name of the client. GST is concerned, GST will be paid on entire 1 crore 50 lakh rupees. No dispute on that. GST is payable on that. As far as provision is concerned, GST has nothing to do with it. The only thing is that when the physically goods are returned, within stipulated period, the GST law is very clear that, you know, for example, financial year March 21, I can do the goods, I can issue the credit note for goods return up to 30th September 2021 as per the old law. And now they have done it 30th November 2021. I can issue the credit note. Suppose this physical jo goods wapis aaya hai, uske samne mujhe credit note issue karna hai. Whatever GST I have paid, that can be adjusted. But if the goods are coming, here is a case of 1 year, November 2021 ke baad goods aayega, so that GST will become the cost to you. Are we clear on this? Yet we have thought of you. Now, now you know, I can take one or two small questions. Non-refundable membership fees. This is the case of, you know, you can take, you know, like club Bendra. This is a, you know, case like the, you know, clubs of the likes of the club Bendra, where it offers the membership for 25 years to the customer against one time
upfront fees of 10 lakh rupees. Are we clear? Saal ka 40,000 rupees from job. You know, they take one time this thing. So Club Mahindra will, I'm not giving you the name of Club Mahindra, it's a Holiday Inn here. That Holiday Inn Club issues the invoice of 10 lakh rupees. The date on which you sign the contract, they will take the check of 10 lakh rupees. So what will be the index implication? Then Gopal will talk about this and then I'll speak about the GST.
Yeah. So obviously it's a period-based income. And you cannot account for it on day one because for the continuation of the benefit of the membership, where they can go and stay, the maintenance cost is also maintenance. You may be recovering cost of administration, the cost of strategy, everything is there. So you cannot say that I have earned this. Now, when you have to spread this, how will you spread it? It's very difficult. This is a case for 5 years in advance. Do you say that there is a financing element? There is no. So done, but it can be challenged that you should look at the financing also because 25 saal ke baad jo paisa aane wala hai wo aaj ki tarikh mein aa gaya. So obviously, aaj if you are receiving 40,000 after 25 years, it has a value of 1 lakh. So what should you should but there are obligations to maintain. Even if the maintenance is taken separately, then the corporate related items and hence
okay. So you know the one of the precedent we are having of a listed company, correct? It's a listed company.
Yeah.
They are following SLM. They are not taking that, you know, IRR and other things, right?
In time value of money is not concerned.
Yeah.
Maybe because each item is small in terms of value, some viewed at that point of time.
Bye-bye.
So thankfully this study doesn't require any reconciliation between tax treatment and accounting
treatment.
Yeah, so what ICDs provide when services are provided by Interplay straight line basis over the specified period. On the Club Mahindra also, there is a Bombay Tribunal Special Bench judgment where they said that the revenue has to be spread over the period of the contract we have agreed. So it's in this case, so it is for 25 years, so the revenue will, on a straight line basis, it will be allocated for. The Bombay High Court has confirmed this view in the sportsified amusement case.
So we have the judicial precedence over it, correct? And we have accounting precedence over it. GST is very simple. The day on which you raise the invoice, sooner the better. GST ka principle. Aaj ka kal mat karo, correct? So you know, GST mein even if you receive the advance against services tax, here you are making the invoice itself, correct? 25 saal ka aapka ek hi saal mein, you know, you pay the tax. Then 10 lakh ke upar 1,80,000 you pay it the first year. Think of the miser, you know, misery of the 24 साल तक उसको 40,000 का रिकंसिलेशन करना पड़ेगा. थिंक ऑफ क्लब मेंबर में भी अभी द लैक्स ऑफ मेंबर्स. तो किसी का 40 साल बाकी है, किसी का 25 साल बाकी है, किसका 22 साल बाकी है, किसका 11 साल बाकी है. वो वर्किंग कैसे करेगा मतलब सच्चा करता है कि वो भी चेक करना पड़ेगा.
will definitely be there. So that is the thing. And now I think, you know, I will take last question, ready before the
break.
Not last, but last before the break.
So yes, sir, please. That is why I just want to add.
Yeah.
So in, even in income tax, one reconciliation is still there.
Oh, okay.
So, so what happened if the other person has deducted tax at source? So you will spread the revenue.
आपके बच्चे लोग भी कंटिन्यू कर सकते हैं
because other charges are separate and additional. So this is like more like an entry fee or.
Now, you know, case study number six.
Sir, one question.
Yeah, please, sorry.
I had a question for ICDS. In the previous example, sir said for that warranty check. So why not in the case of the warranty, warranty also next year only will recognize instead of year, then you have an option to follow the service contract, like since it is more than 90 days. So you go based on the matching concept also. So you can recognize corresponding revenue. But then that option is also available because that ICD is otherwise silent on that part.
Now, case study number six, unbilled revenue. The case study facts are like this. A company enters into an agreement on 15 January 2021, 15 January, with a customer for providing the consultancy service on the monthly basis. This could be consultancy or even the annual maintenance contract. That you know, monthly maintenance contract also can be there. Where the billing cycle is 16 to 15. So my bill for 16 January 21 to 15th February will be in the next year. Now, cutoff year lenge, hum log sabse March ka lenge. So March mein 16th March to 15th April, that bill will be done in the month of the 15th April 2021. So there is an unbilled revenue. Unbilled revenue for 15 days. March 21 mein aapka 15 se leke 31st ka revenue come. So what will be the in-depth treatment for this particular unbilled revenue?
Naresh, aapne case study change kar.
Kyo?
Aapne consultancy ke baad AMC da. Thoda, till the extent of 31st of March as unbilled revenue. And unbilled revenue in certain industries is a very, very common feature, especially in IT and even in case of PR and advertising and other key. In the Schedule 3 itself now, so it is recognized that certain services or your obligation. As accrued income, subject to that, this is not any.
Under ICDS also, so for service contract, percentage completion. So, like whatever that you're making.
And as far as GST is concerned, Milan Bhai is accounting as a revenue. But GST will recognize the revenue because it is a continuous supply of services. And continuous supply of services, the time of supply is the date on which you are entitled to receive the contractual payment. So I am entitled to receive the contractual payment on 15th April 2021, correct? So I will raise the invoice on 15th April 2021. I will pay the GST. Here the GST takes, you know, the for change.
Postponement. There is a
postponement of the GST. But GST is very simple. Raise the invoice, pay the tax. ये कोई लफड़ा ही नहीं है सब रिकंसिलिएशन का
पहली बार जीएसटी इतना सिंपल है
हां सर बहुत सिंपल है सर मैं बोलता हूं आपको मैं मिलन भाई के साथ बेटा गोपाल के साथ बेटा तो मैं बोला आई एम ब्लेस्ड दैट आई एम इन जीएसटी आई एम नॉट इन दैट प्लेस सो आई थिंक यू नो इन दैट केस देयर विल बी रिकंसिलिएशन आई वी डोंट डिस्कस मच सो विद दिस वी ब्रेक फॉर द
ब्रेक
सर ओनली वन थिंग इज दैट सर As far as you know, the TDS will come in by April 21, na? Milan bhai.
Next year.
पहले TDS आएगा तो तुम वो defer कर सकते हो, लेकिन बाद में TDS है तो उसका क्या करने का?
वो party ने provision basis पे deduct किया जैसे audit fees का होता है वैसे कर सकते हैं।
Provision नहीं कर, provision पे नहीं करेंगे ना TDS, BS जो है।
No sir,
नहीं। हाँ, उसका जो मेरे को समझो थोड़ा।
So there will be difference.
Control.
No, I'm just saying so like.
Yeah, you have to carry forward the cost as what you put. So in the case of AMC, which she mentioned, even though you have not taken an example, in AMC, we maintain. So revenue will come in the subsequent period because your cost is going to come in that period. Suppose I cannot book the full revenue because the service is going to come in the actual cost is going to come in the next period. So hence.
Let's break for the chai wali ke liye
sir actually break ko karte hain fresh wali dekha na dono side equally
ha
lovely both the sides
ha left wing and right wing
abhi maza aa raha hai na
aapko maza aa raha hai kyun baat nahi aapko to maza aa raha
hai are are aaj dekho naaste ke liye koi advance mein
nahi wo to sab sawal hi nahi hai so hamara pehle ka to utta nahi hai sir
पूरा बंद करना है।